Hello students, in today's session of work power energy, very basics of kinetic energy and work energy theorem will be cleared through illustrations. In the earlier session we have gone through these, which you can review on citizenship law. I will also like to say detailed solution of these two papers available on website cetisip.com. You can have the solution by visiting the site. इसी के साथ साथ मैं आप लोगों से रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा कि अगर अब तक आपने यूट्यूब चैनल सेटिसिप सब्सक्राइब नहीं किया प्लीज सब्सक्राइब इट एंड शेयर विद योर फ्रेंड्स एंड कोलीग्स. नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द कॉन्सेप्ट एंड क्वेश्चंस. Concept regarding kinetic energy and work energy theorem. Kinetic energy is the capacity of a body to do the work by virtue of its position. Do the work by virtue of its position. Right? And if force F is acting on a particle and its velocity rises from 0 to V, the kinetic energy will be equal to half mv square. Then you can know. You know force equal to m into A. V square equal to U square plus twice A S. The 0 plus twice A S. So this comes out to be as equal to V square by 2A. Work done will be equal to now F S. M into A into S. That is M into A into V square by 2A. This A goes, that is half M V square. That is work done equal to half mv square. So what is work energy theorem? Work energy theorem is change in kinetic energy, that is work done by all the forces on a particle. All the forces means forces may be conservative, may be non-conservative, friction, air resistance, pseudo force, whatever the force may be. Work done by all the forces acting on a particle is equal to change in kinetic energy, that is Kf minus Ki. That is the work energy theorem. That is very, very useful theorem to find the work done. Now, let's start with the question. Question is, an object of mass 5 kg falls from rest through a vertical distance of 20 meter and attains a velocity of 10 meter per second. How much work is done by the resistance of air on the object? Concept applicable. Work energy theorem. What is that? Work done by all the forces acting on a object equal to change in kinetic energy, that is Kf minus Ki. Here F is half mv square. That is half 5 into 10 chi square. 50, 150, 250 joule. And initially, velocity is 0, therefore delta Ke will be equal to Kf minus Ki equal to 250 minus 0, that is 250 joule. Change in kinetic energy. And forces will be worked done by the two forces are to weight, that is mg plus air resistance, worked done by air resistance. That should be equal to delta Ke, that is equal to 250 joule. Therefore, worked done by air resistance on the object will be equal to delta Ke minus mgh, that is 250 minus m is 5, 10, 10. This comes out to work done by half mv square. And that's 20, 10, 5, 5, this is 20. This comes out 250 minus 200, 1000. That comes out to minus 150. Joule. Work done by air resistance. Is 750. So that is the answer. Right? Next question. Question is the displacement x of a particle moving in one dimension under the action of a constant force is related to time t given by t equal to root x plus c, where x is in meter, t is in second. Calculate A part. The displacement of the particle when its velocity is 0. B part. The work done by the force in first 6 seconds. Concept applicable in solution. You know, given a t equal to root x plus 3. To find karna humne displacement of the particle when velocity to find x when velocity equal to 0. Velocity means dx by dt equation. That is differentiation will be required. Differentiation will be required. Therefore, x will be equal to t minus 3, x equal to t minus 3 whole square. This is equation 2. This is equation 2. Differentiating equation 2 with respect to t. Velocity v will be equal to dx by dt equal to d by dt t minus 3 whole square. Formula applicable. D by dt x ax plus b to power n, that is n ax plus b to power n minus into a. This is the formula to give for differentiation. Right? Now, therefore, this comes out to twice t minus 3 into coefficient to T1, that is twice T minus 3. This is the velocity. To find T when V equal to 0. Therefore, T minus 3 equal to 0. T equal to 3 seconds. T equal to 3 seconds, therefore, displacement at T equal to 3 seconds. Substituting in equation 1. Velocity comes out to be 3 minus 3 whole square, that is 0. 0 meter per second. This is first part answer. Second, we have to find the work done by the force in B part. First 6 seconds according to Work-Energy Theorem. Work done will be equal to change in kinetic energy. Then Vt equal to 0 or Vt equal to 6 seconds. V equal to 0 from equation 3. This equation 3. V comes out to be twice 3 minus 3, that is 0 minus 3, that is minus 6 meter per second. And from 3, V equal to twice 6 minus 3, that is 6 meters per second. Therefore, work done by the force in first 6 seconds will be equal to kinetic energy final minus kinetic energy initial. That is half m Vf square minus half m V square, substituting values half m 6 square minus half m minus 6 square, that is half m into 36 m minus half 36 m. This goes, this comes out to the answer 0. This is the part B answer. So this is the application of work energy theorem, right? Now I would like to request, if you are new to my YouTube channel City Shift Learn, please like and subscribe to my channel and press bell icon to receive updates on concept killing videos. Thank you.